Hey everyone, welcome back to another mining chamber video. In this video, we will talk about the top 5 GPUs for mining while keeping in mind Ethereum 2.0. So I will be comparing 4 different algorithms to mine with the GPUs, and I will also address the low hash rate limiter by NVIDIA and some other information that will help you move forward in your GPU mining journey. So let's go ahead and get into it right after the intro. The first thing I want to make clear is that this is all in my opinion. I do provide numbers that support my opinion, but there's always room for a human error. If I did miss something or overlooked a GPU, please let me know in the comments below. Buying a GPU now can be scary due to Ethereum 2.0 coming around the corner. So if you're unaware of Ethereum 2.0 and the issue around it, feel free to watch my video on that topic, which will be linked in the descriptions below. So let's talk about the Lite Hashrate Identifier. So NVIDIA recently did this thing where they're trying to let miners not use their cards for mining, but instead they wasted resources on really bad mining dedicated cards that can't even be reused by gamers. Honestly, it's silly. So this Lite Hashrate label, or LHR, is only for ETH-hash algorithm, which includes Ethereum and Ethereum Classic. Ethereum is going to proof of stake within this year or the beginning of next year, so by then that LHR label is not effective anymore. There is also a lot of cryptos on the rise lately that can compete with the profitability of Ethereum, so I don't think that the label is going to stop miners at all. I would have rather them avoid wasting chips on cards that can be recycled within the community in a global chip shortage. But unfortunately, we can't do much about it. Now, one more common question that I see very often is, what is the lifespan of a GPU that mines 24/7? This will most likely surprise you if you're a new miner, but they can easily mine for at least 5 plus years if taken proper measures. Now, of course, luck plays a role in this too, so if you get a bad silicon card or just a bad GPU in general, then you are unfortunate and it might die a lot sooner. But in general, if you keep them in cool conditions and not too hot by proper undervolting and airflow, as well as frequently dusting them, then you will be all set. Overclocking and undervolting plays a big role in this, and I do talk about it a lot in a video about this topic. So if you're new to it, I highly suggest opening that video in a new tab so you can watch it next. You will also be able to find different overclocks on miningchamber.com for most of the algorithms that I will be going over in this video. So now for the GPU comparison, I will be showing you the top 4 algorithms as of the date of this video. So do keep in mind that these top 4 might change around, but what will remain unchanged is the hash rate per watt and potentially the hash rate per dollar. These are two ways to compare the GPUs for mining. One is based on efficiency through the wattage, and the other is based on maximizing your budget potential. Now that being said, let's go ahead and run a quick word from this video sponsor and then move on to the top 5. This video is sponsored by Skillshare. Skillshare is an online learning platform that helps you expand your knowledge in various fields. They have a variety of classes about almost every topic you can think of, from creativity, storytelling, and cryptocurrency basics. I personally am a sucker for learning new things and obtaining more knowledge, so I will be using Skillshare to improve my editing, writing, and video composition skills to bring you guys higher quality content with more digestible bits of information. If you're looking to pursue a hobby in the digital world or learning more about cryptocurrency basics, then I highly suggest checking out Skillshare.com. The first 1,000 of my subscribers that click on the link in the descriptions will get a free trial for the premium membership, so you can go ahead and explore your creativity with Skillshare today. Thank you, Skillshare, for sponsoring this video. So now back to the top 5 GPUs for mining. So what I'm going to be covering while comparing them is, first you have the price for the GPU as well as the PCIe connectors and how they do in 4 algorithms. Now in these 4 algorithms, I'll be showing you a table on the screen that shows megahash per watt and megahash per dollar. I'm not going to be stating all the megahash per watt, megahash per dollar for all the GPUs because I will probably sound really annoying, so instead you can just see them on the screen or you can visit the article on miningchamber.com. But what you need to know about megahash per watt, the more the better, so that means you can get more megahash per the power that you're using. And then for the megahash per dollar, the less the better, so that means the megahash that you're buying is cheaper, and that means you're maximizing your budget. So now with that being said, let's go ahead and go to the top 5 GPU for mining, which will be the NVIDIA GTX 1660 Ti or Super. The 1660 Ti and Super are pretty old cards, but they're still fairly efficient. They run on super low power, which makes them a great choice if you just want something quiet and without that much heat. And both of them do fairly well in other algorithms, but the Ti is better than the Super in other algorithms. Now the numbers I'll be giving here will be for the Ti, but just keep in mind the Super will get slightly less in other algorithms than ETH-hash. So the current price of these GPUs, you can find them for $550 USD. and the MSRP they came out with is $279. And the top 4 algorithms that you can mine on them as the time that I'm filming this video is, first you have Ethash, and then you have Autolycos and Kapow, as well as MTP. So in Ethash you'll be getting around 31 megahash with 80 watts, and then on Ergo you'll be getting around 48 megahash with 80 watts. Kapow will also give you 13.4 megahash with 90 watts, and then MTP will give you 2.1 megahash for 100 watts. You can feel free to pause the video if you want to look at the megahash per watt or megahash per dollar, but this will only be good data to compare with other GPUs. So now we can go to our top 4, which is the RTX 2080 Ti or Super. Now this card is also from an older gen, but the price for it in my opinion is a bit too much. But since that goes for the other GPUs as well, since everything inflated in price, then this makes this card a viable option. And same as the 1660 Ti in Super, the Ti one does better in other algorithms, but the Super does the same in the Ethash algorithm. Now for the scalper price of these cards, you'll get it around $1,550 USD, or the MSRP of $1,000. And then you have the same exact top 4 algorithms for the 1660s. So on Ethash you'll be getting around 58 megahash on 180 watts, and then on Ergo you'll get around 108 megahash for 160 watts, and Kapow will give you 31.50 megahash for 220 watts, and MTP will give you 4.8 megahash for 220 watts. Now one thing about this card is that it's not that efficient, so it does consume a pretty good amount of power, and I'm sure you can overclock this further and make it more efficient. I personally don't have this card, so I couldn't test these numbers myself and change them around for more efficiency. Now in the number 3 spot you have the NVIDIA RTX 3080s. Now the RTX 3080s is one of the most powerful GPUs out there, but that unfortunately comes with two negatives. The first one is that the price tag on this card is insane, so it's not budget friendly at all. And then the second thing is the thermal issues, where you have to replace the thermal pads on them if you're throttling and having all these different issues with these cards. And that is why I have it placed as the third. Now for the scalper price on this GPU, you can find it for around $2,200, and the MSRP for it was $700. It can take anywhere from 2 to 3 8-pin connectors, and the top 4 algorithms on it, you have Ethash, Autolycos, Octopus, as well as Kapow. So the only difference is you don't have MTP on there, instead you have Octopus. Now on Ethash you'll be getting around 98 megahash for 230 watts, and on Ergo you'll get 190 megahash for 180 watts. On Octopus algorithm you'll be getting around 84 megahash for 255 watts, and then on Kapow you'll be getting around 43 megahash for 255 watts. And now we can go ahead and go to top 2. Now top 2 will probably surprise you, and it also surprised me as well, and that is the 6800 XT or regular. Now honestly I never paid attention to this GPU for mining. I thought all the 6000 series are not that good, but some great person in the comment section made me look into this card, and after I looked into it, honestly, it's a really good card for mining. Now, one of the pros for it is that the price for it did not inflate as much as the NVIDIA cards, because in general, miners are not looking for these cards as much as the NVIDIA cards, so which means for a good price, you'll be getting some really good performance. But one problem with these cards is that they are less efficient. So this would be a great option if you're trying to maximize performance with cheap electricity. So these cards currently go for around 1,400 USD scalper price, and MSRP is around $579, and they take in 2 8-pin connectors. So the top 4 algorithms for this card, first you have Ethash, and then you have Autolycos, because Ergo has been going up in price, so you can see this algorithm more often in other GPUs as well. And then you have Kryptonite GPU, the Ryo currency, and then you have Raven Coin. So for Ethash you'll be getting around 62 megahash for 128 watts, which is not bad at all, and for Ergo you'll be getting 110 megahash for 150 watts. Kryptonite GPU, you'll get around 1593 hash rate per second for 105 watts, and then for Kapow you'll get 28 megahash for 155 watts. Which places this card as top 2 because it does pretty well on other algorithms, so it's not just Ethereum dominant. And then finally the top 1 option. Now I'm sure you guys saw this one coming, but it will be the RTX 3070 and the 3060 Ti. The reason I have both of them here because they both are really good cards for mining. Although one thing that differentiates them is that the 3070 is more future-proof than the 3060 Ti because the 3070 excels more in other algorithms. Now both of these cards come for the same price, you'll find them around 1500 USD, and the MSRP for the 3070 is $500, while for the 3060 Ti it's $400. And they also take anywhere from 1 to 2 8-pin connectors. Now for the top 5 algorithms, I have two different tables for them so you can see the differences between the efficiency, and they have the same exact algorithm as the 3080. So for Ethash, you'll get around 61 megahash for 125 watts on both cards, and then for Ergo, you'll have 155 megahash and 130 watts for both cards as well. And then on Octopus and Kapow, you have some different numbers here. The RTX 3070 will be doing around 58 megahash on 145 watts, while the 3060 Ti does 45 megahash on 120 watts. And then on Ravencoin, the 3070 would do 30 megahash on 145 watts, while the 3060 Ti does 22 megahash on 120 watts. So that puts in perspective the megahash per watt as well as the megahash per dollar. So in my opinion, look for 3070s, but if you find 3060 Ti's for a lot cheaper, then it's definitely another great option. So now that wraps up the top 5 GPUs for mining, and now let me just give you some honorable mentions in case you guys are wondering. So first you have the RTX 3090s. Now these cards are super expensive, and that's the reason they're not on this list. But their power is still really well. And one more downside to them is that they are like the 3080s, where they get really hot, so you have to change the thermal pads, and they also consume a lot of power. But if you do find them for a cheap price, you can go for it, but honestly, I don't recommend them at all. And then you also have the Polaris cards, which is the AMD cards anywhere from 400 to 500 series. Now those cards are great, and the 4GB version of them also looks like a good option now, because Ethereum is going away and the other coins don't need more than 4GB of VRAM to mine them, so you can use those 4GB cards for cheap and mine other coins. Now I would only recommend them if you can find them for a decent price, so if it's $200 and below, then it's a great deal, but if it's not, then you need to be careful. I would rather go with the 1660 Ti or Super if they're at the same price point. And now that is it for the GPUs for cryptocurrency mining. So now before I wrap up the video, I just want to tell you guys my opinion on this situation and whether you should be buying GPUs for mining right now or not. So honestly, one thing that I'm really against is scalpers. So buying GPUs at scalper prices will only motivate them to keeping the price at that point. Unfortunately, there isn't much that we can do about it other than trying to get deals and waiting for MSRP drops. So your back might be on the wall if you want to start cryptocurrency mining as soon as possible, which means you'll end up having to buy a GPU for scalper price. Now this guide should help you whether it's scalper price or MSRP price. Just use this as a starting point to decide which GPU you want to use. I personally am looking to build another mining rig, and it will be with the 6800s. So until I get enough for them for a rig, I will be building it very soon. And I will also have a GPU overview video on those cards as soon as possible, so you guys can use it for your overclocks. And talking about overclocks, I do have a playlist with different GPU videos where I go over the most profitable coin to mine with them and then show you the different overclocks for it. So if you're interested in checking out the different GPUs, I will link that playlist in the descriptions below. And I don't really announce this, but if you guys want any mining chamber clothing or just mining clothing in general, feel free to check out store.miningchamber.com. I do have a couple of clothing there with different designs, so if any of them interest you and you want to support the channel, then this would be an awesome way to do so. But only if you actually like the design. So now that being said, I hope you guys enjoyed this video and learned something new. If you have any feedback or any questions, leave them in the comments below, and also let me know which GPU is your favorite for mining and which ones are you planning to buy if you're planning to expand. I've recently released the top 5 PSUs for mining, and if you haven't watched that yet, then I highly suggest that you watch that as well. It has some really good information on how to power up your GPUs. And now you also have the top 5 GPUs for mining. Now the next video I'm planning to release is the top 5 motherboards for mining, so make sure to subscribe and turn on the bell notification so you get notified when that video is out. And on your way out, make sure to hit that like button. Thank you guys so much for watching, and I hope you have a wonderful day.